Hi, it's Peter Nixon reporting from the Potential Dialogue Institute studio here in Hong Kong. And as I share this message about how stress affects us, in the background, you'll be watching protests, street protests from around the world, including right here in Hong Kong. As you know, the world is erupting with Black Lives Matter, with democracy protests, with economic problems, with the pandemic problems. And in a lot of countries around the world, the governments are retreating into their bunkers, and dialogue between government and people isn't really working. These are complicated situations. And in these next two videos, I will share two stories about two suitcases. In the first story, I will explain how conflict affects us. And then I'll invite you back to watch the second story about a second suitcase to explain how we can de-escalate stress and conflict and move forward in dialogue. And then obviously these can be applied in the more complex situations that are unraveling on the video as I speak. In the first story, this goes back many years ago when shortly after I had moved to Hong Kong and my wife arrived at the airport from her summer vacation with an excessively large suitcase. And I had previously said, if you bring a really big suitcase, like one of these big hockey bags, I can't move it. It's going to kill my back. I'm going to get a hernia. And she arrives at the airport with a giant bag full of all of the wonderful things she had picked up from her family during the summer. And trying to be kind, I try to move it. It was unbelievable. Nobody can move anything like that, especially in Hong Kong. In Canada, it's different. You have a car, you throw it in the back of your car, you drive to the airport, put it on a trolley. In Hong Kong, you've got to carry those things. You've got to move on public transit. Anyway, it was hot. It was frustrating that I hadn't been listened to. It wasn't working. We struggled to get the suitcase all the way to Hong Kong from the airport, the old airport, to Discovery Bay, some 3 hours from the turnstile when the bag comes out, to actually getting home. And the final bit, the last mile, I needed to get the bag, the suitcase, onto the public bus to go up the mountain, because I couldn't carry it up the mountain and there was no other option. And as I pulled it up the steps into the bus driver said, cannot. And he actually got out of his seat and started pushing against the suitcase. And when I saw that, I lost it. I had been triggered, obviously, from the heat, from the upset of the size of the bag, from the rather frustrating reception I got from a jet-lagged wife that I hadn't seen for weeks. And I just lost it. So I took the coins from my hand. This was all before we had stored value cards. Took the coins from my hand for the bus, threw them at the bus driver. To which, of course, escalation happened. He turns off the bus. All the passengers are angry. They have to get out of the bus. They call the police. And we talk about what happened. In the end, they turned back on the bus. The passengers got the ride home. And I apologized. And they arranged for me to get the bag home. So it was a pretty big bit of learning. A lot was happening there. First of all, I had been triggered by the heat, the situation, the upset, the physical, to me, the moral breach of the driver pushing against my bag instead of offering to help me with my bag. I could have even given him a tip. So everything was going wrong and I just snapped. And we all snap. And the important thing was I didn't obviously do the right thing, and it didn't lead to a positive outcome. So that story is important as we consider the conflicts that are happening around the world and what else is happening and how we might possibly do that better. So a few things that I just want to highlight as I play this tape again. First of all, conflict triggers are natural. the culture in which we operate and the different cultures can also trigger a reaction. Lack of self-awareness, the things that have happened before, they're all things that can cause us troubles. And if you don't have a better way of reacting, then you'll react the wrong way. You'll react your natural way. And my natural way is to jump up and do something. So I jumped up and I threw coins in the driver's face, and that was absolutely the wrong thing to do. I'm going to switch from this into some slides. So let me just pause this. Some of the key points: how does stress change us? Keep your head when all bets are losing theirs and blaming it on you. My suitcase story: I lost my head. I didn't control my emotions, and it didn't make my situation better. I was up in stage three, four. It was leading to violence, and then it led to silence because my wife wouldn't talk to me, and it was very ineffective. One of the things we know is that people change in predictable ways. So if you do our two modules on motives and behaviors, you'll learn how you change as stress escalates. We know also that people's focus narrows when they're stressed. So for example, I no longer cared about all the people on the bus. I didn't even notice the people on the bus. I only noticed the problem, which was my getting my bag onto the bus. And in the end, I defaulted into myself. So we'll lose focus on the other people. We'll lose focus on the problem, because at that point I couldn't even get on the bus and I was stuck, and it took even longer to get home. So that's important. It's also important to recognize that usually there's two arrows. The first thing you can't do anything about. I couldn't have done anything about the heat of the evening, that summer evening in Hong Kong. The fact that my wife was jet lagged, I couldn't do anything about that. The fact that it takes 3 hours from then Kai Tak to get to Hong Kong to Discovery Bay, nothing I could do about that. But I could respond to this mean bus driver in a better way. And that's something that comes with learning and practice. Something else that we know that fuels the intensity of my reaction: it was important to me to get my wife home. I wasn't close to life or death, and it wasn't a timing problem. But if I had have known that I couldn't bring the bag on the bus beforehand, it might have helped. I was charged. When it happened, I was charged. I was already loaded. I was ready to explode. I was not emotionally self-aware, and these things kept bugging me. I got more and more irritated as I got closer to the house. My temperament is normally calm, cool, and collected, so it was something that my wife at the time had not even seen in me. Culturally, there's differences where you are in the world and the culture that you bring to the situation. You can be more or less emotionally expressive and more or less confrontational. To me, as a Canadian, I think when I found a moral injustice that the bus driver would be pushing my bag out the door rather than helping me. I think that's what really tipped it off culturally. And culturally, to give him full credit, I was breaking the rules and I was disrupting his bus service. So I understand also where he's coming from. We know what the big destructive emotions are in both East and West, and that might be of interest to some of you in this module when we go into deeper points. But the big thing is there's got to be a pause between the trigger and your response. And when he pushed my bag, there was no pause. I just pulled the coins out of my pocket and I threw them at him. And so that was part of my mistake. Now you can get better. You can be like I was in that situation, where you can move all the way up to having compassion for the bus driver, which I'm working on. It doesn't come to me naturally, but as my family knows, I am working on it. Some of the situations now that we live in with our always on mobile phones, this sort of thing, this is causing us to be less and less able to focus on our emotions and to concentrate on the situation, and especially to be mindful when something goes wrong, that we don't just react without thinking. So we need to be conscious of that. The coronavirus has set everybody off, And it's obviously set off even escalated trade war between USA and China. I won't go into other details. If you do have questions, just post them. And if you're interested, sign up for our module. We'd love to train you and do more. But if you're curious about the story of the second suitcase, tune in for the next video and you'll hear the story of the second suitcase, another one similar to the first one, but happy to say with a better outcome. So thank you for listening to my story of the suitcase.